Very good morning, dear students. How are you all? I hope everyone is fine. So let's start with our lesson. We have started the lesson sources of food. In the last video, we have learned about from where do we get the food? Is the food necessary for our health? Is the food necessary for our body? Yes, we need a food. Am I right? The food gives us energy. It helps us to grow. Similarly, from where do we get the food? We get the food from either from plants or animals. Now, what about the animals? Where do they get the food from? Yes, they get the food from the plants. Right? Some animals get the food from the plants. Some they hunt the other animals and get their food. Yes or no? Now, what about the plants? From where do they get the food? Yes, they get the food from the sun, and they have a special pigment that is the green pigment that is called as a chlorophyll. Am I right? Because of the chlorophyll, they can prepare their own food. Only on the earth there is only one of the living thing which can prepare their food, that is plant. The plants can make their own food. Plants are the living thing which can make their own food. How do they make their food? They have a green pigment that is called chlorophyll. They have a pigment that is called as a chlorophyll, and with the help of the sunlight, they can prepare their food. Are you getting? So everyone, now as you know, the animals, that is you, even the human beings, we all are depend on the plants. Yes or no? As they prepare their own food, we cannot prepare the food. We just make the food. We just bring all the things from the market and we can make the food. Am I right? We cannot make the leaf, we cannot make the tomato or different types of the varieties of the food that we are getting from the either from the plants or the animals. Are you getting? And because of this, now once we get the food, we get energy. Am I right? Similarly, the energy is transferred from one animal to the another. One animal to the animals. Now see, the plant prepare their food, am I right? And that, and as they prepare their food, they get an energy which helps them to grow. Yes? So, and because of that, once we are getting, then we are eating some of the plants such as spinach, we eat the plants and we get the energy. Yes or no? So, the energy which is prepared by the plants, that is taken by us, and that is in this way we can transfer the energy. Are you getting? So that is called the food chain. That is a food chain. Now for example, if you will see, the plants prepare their own food. Am I right? And that energy, now grass is eaten by the deer. The grass is eaten by the deer. Am I right? So whatever the energy the grass means, work by preparing the food, they can get the energy, and after eating, this energy will transfer to the deer. When the deer will eat the grass, automatically he is going to get the energy. Yes or no? And when deer will be eaten by the lion, then the energy is going to transfer from deer to the lion. Yes or no? So directly or indirectly, we all are depend on the plants. Directly or indirectly. Now see, why I say that indirectly? See, deer is directly depend on the grass, but lion is indirectly depend on the grass. Now how? See, if there will be no deer, then what the lion will eat? The lion cannot eat the grass. Yes or no? So lion is indirectly depend on the plants, am I right? So we all are depend on the plants. So this is one of the example of the food chain. The next is grass. Grasshopper is eaten by the frog. frog is eaten by the snake and snake is eaten by the eagle. Am I right? So this is one of the food chain. Means the grasshopper will eat grass. Am I right? Then frog will eat grasshopper. Means the frog indirectly depend on the grass. Yes or no? They are indirectly depend on the plants. Am I right? So we can define the food chain as a series of organisms linked together by the process of eating, or being eaten for the food, means the process of eating. Now the grasshopper is going to eat the grass. Am I right? And being eaten for the food. The frog will eat grasshopper. The frog is going to eat grasshopper. Am I right? So it will be eaten for the food. Because of the food, the frog will totally depend on the grasshopper. Am I right? Yes or no? The frog will eaten by the grasshopper for food. Am I right? So that the frog is going to get the energy. So a food chain is defined as a series of organisms linked together by the process of eating and being eaten for the food. Are you getting this? So this is, we can say indirectly or directly, we depend on the plants. All the living things are depend on the plants for the source of energy. Are you getting? Then the next point is about food problem. Now you can see there are the number of, due to this pandemic situation, you can see the number of jobs are lost, and the more amount of the people or large amount of the population, they do not get the food. What is the problem behind this? See, why there is a problem of food problem? Because of the shortage of food. There is a very less amount of the food. So because of that, the poor people do not get the food. And because of that, many of the people died. Am I right? The death rate has been increased due to the scarcity of the food. The first reason is shortage of the food. There is a very less amount of the food. So we are facing the food problem. Second, we cannot serve poor people. They do not buy the food. They cannot buy the food because of the poverty. Because of the poorness, they cannot buy the enough amount of the food. Are you getting? Then what is the solution? What we can do? There should be some solution. As we know, India is the largest, it has a large amount of the population. Yes, it has a varieties of the people in India. There are different varieties of the people in India, and as they have a largest amount of the population, we need a food. So the reason, every problem, there should be some kind of solution. Yes or no? We should find a solution. We should not keep all the problems. See, I have this much problem. How I can face? We should find a solution. So what is the solution of the food problem? We should grow more and more amount of the food, means grain or the food products, by using the modern method of technology. We have to use the modern method of technology so that we can grow more and more amount of food. Now due to this natural calamities, there is a very loss of the food grains. Am I right? Due to this natural calamities, there is a very large amount of the loss of food grains. So we have to use the new technique, that is modern method of tending. Then we should store the food properly. We are getting the food, but we are not storing the food properly. They have been eaten by the insects or the rat. So we should store the food properly. And the last, whenever we are going in a hotels or whenever we are going outside, we are throwing the lot amount of the food. So we should not waste the food. Are you getting this? So in this way we have completed the lesson. So my dear students, I hope you have understood it, and now start solving the exercise. just today you will solve the MCQs and collect the brands through Google Meet. Thank you.